There have been several stories out of the Northwest Province this week, and we're now joined by the EFF's provincial chair, Betty Diale. Ms. Diale, thank you for being with us. So let's just outline the problem. So yesterday we had a raid on the Northwest Premier's office in relation to an IT firm and claims of corruption there. Then there are claims around health. We've just run the private ambulances being procured. We know about Mediosa, the mobile units, and that company linked to the Guptas. Is that a fair assessment? Are these the issues that are at stake in the Northwest?
Indeed. Thank you very much. Let me greet the viewers. It is indeed the case that there are several cases of corruption that are exposed in the Northwest Province. So those are the reasons why we actually want to pass a motion of no confidence against the Premier of the province.
What evidence do you have? Because, I mean, yesterday he welcomed the Hawks raid. What evidence do you have that he's involved in any of this?
The departments that are involved, particularly the health department as well as public works, are the departments that are under administration since 2015. Now, you'd imagine if the departments are under administration, the MEC for health, for MEC for finance, as well as the Premier himself, are involved in the bigger transactions that are taking place in those departments. In fact, evidence that was tendered in the legislature confirms that the Premier even authorized a trip by the HOD and his colleague to India immediately prior to the payments of the 30 million rand. Also in the 103 million rand transaction done in the public works department, the Premier is fully involved in that transaction. The Premier is head of the province. It is clear that the center is not holding. It is clear that the Premier can't perform his functions as a Premier of the province.
All right, but approving a trip to India, is that enough? Is that enough evidence? And that was before there were any claims.
That's not all there is. There are invoices. There's clear they've not even denied paying that. It is clear that the payments was even done immediately after he has confirmed that he's bringing the Guptas into the province. It is very clear that it is his involvement. We've got invoices. We've got proof of payments. It was actually even confirmed by the department that he actually authorized those trips. Mm-hmm. He actually knows about the transactions. He knows about the transaction also in the Department of Public Works. So it is very clear that the Premier has a hand in this. You'd imagine also the raiding yesterday by the Hawks in his office confirmed that the NEPO, there are transactions made from the Premier's coffers. Clearly, the Premier should be involved. It's from his own office, from the budget of the Premier's office. So it is clear that the Premier is very corrupt. Transactions made to NEPO amounts to over 200 million rand, and the transactions were done almost on daily basis. So it is very clear that it can't be any other way the Premier is involved.
It's interesting what you said. So there were two departments, health and public works, that were presumably performing very badly. They were taken over by the province. That's when the province steps in to make things better. And you say since then, corruption has been rife. So it's like going from the frying pan into the fire, basically.
Indeed, it has been the case. It went even worse in the administration of Premier Suprama Humapelo. The Department of Health was once the best department in our province, but since the fifth administration led by Premier Suprama Humapelo, the Department of Health has deteriorated dismally. It has deteriorated. There's no service for our people. There's also corruption happening with the Buthelezi ambulance transactions. That private company cost the department 10 million rand a month. You can imagine there are ambulances that are available for the department that are parked apparently because they don't have registration numbers. I don't know how that happens when there are interrelations between the departments. Why that is not done to get the ambulances registered? Why are we using private ambulances? Mm. They're costing a lot of money. At the end of the day, now you can even hear that the department has written letters to employees and service providers within the department to say they will not be funded, they will not be paid until the end of the financial year. In other words, the health department is waiting for the next financial year to pay its service providers. It is very clear that there are no funds anymore in the department, and we can't run a province like that.
So finally, The Northwest, if I remember, there's strong support for the ANC. Are you trying to get political mileage out of this call for a motion, or do you believe that you could actually drum up the support to ensure that this goes through? Just explain the political landscape that you're working within.
We have many reasons to believe that we can get mileage over this. We have done our job, we have done our work as the economic freedom fighters and the opposition as well. We are working very hard to ensure that the motion passes. They just have to give us our constitutional right to have it done in secret, in terms of the secret ballot, and wait and see.
All right, thank you very much. The EFF's provincial chair in the Northwest Province, Betty Diale.